Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Mr. Meech, and I'm back. Sorry I've been absent the past few weeks. I've just had a crazy go of it lately, and I'm just now getting back into the swing of things and back to, like, to a place where I can start making videos again. But just a little bit about the situation I was in, so you guys just know what was happening. If you count this as, like, a second job, as if YouTube's a second job, I also got a third job that I do at night, so that kind of messed my sleep schedule up, and I don't really have very much free time. However, now that it's been a few weeks, I'm getting back into the normal, like, I'm getting a routine that I can keep up and maintain, so I'm back and I'm maybe making some videos. Also, in my last video I asked if there was anybody who'd be willing to draw me an avatar, because I'm a trash artist. And to my very, very, very happy surprise, I actually got some submissions. While some of them were just straight up golden memes like some of these ones, I actually got some like legit submissions too, and I freaking love both of them. The one I'm gonna go with is done by an Instagram account with the name of Kanolru Low. I'm so sorry if I butchered that. Kanolru Low, I think is how you say it. I'm gonna link all her stuff. Everything's on screen. It's gonna be in the description. Go check them out. They're so awesome. They do a bunch of animation stuff, it looks like. And I'm really, really appreciative from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much. This is awesome. Like, look at this freaking picture. It's so freaking cool. Got one of my favorite art styles from one of my favorite shows, so thank you so, so, so much. I'm debating whether to make it the profile of my channel, like the picture. So what do you guys think? Should I keep the Smash Ball that I have now, or should I use this picture of me? So let me know. Now, onto today's topic. I'm sure, as most of y'all watching are Smash fans, you guys know or have at least played once or twice on the online for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Now, it's not the worst online mode ever implemented into a game. It's not. But there are so, so many things wrong with online for Ultimate. Like, there are just so many things that it leaves to be desired. And I'm going to be talking about 7 different ways that Nintendo could, they probably won't because they're freaking lazy and just terrible at online for some reason, but 7 ways they could improve the online play for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'm going to be talking about things that are wrong with the online mode, and I'm going to be talking about ways I think it could be fixed. I'm not a game designer. There could be other and better ways that these things could be addressed, but these changes are just coming from someone who would like to see these shortcomings addressed and given an opinion on how to fix it. First off, this is the infamous one. Everybody talks about it. Well, one of the infamous ones. There's 2 that are really, really bad. But everybody complains about all the time, say it with me now, the internet, the servers, the connectivity. It just needs to happen. It needs to be corrected. It's not really correct to say that they need better servers, but it's also kind of correct at the same time. The reason that the online connectivity is so bad, it's kind of complicated, but I'm gonna try to give a very oversimplified version. So when you're playing online, each frame that your game is processing is sending each frame of input out to other players in the session. So basically, every frame it's like, okay, there was an input, there was internet sufficient enough to give it out to other players in the session. And when other players' games are reaching out to yours, they're doing the same thing. They're asking what your controller did in that frame or whatever, if anything at all. And if someone in the server does not send out an input, the game will freeze until someone whose input didn't get sent out gets sent out. And then the game will go back to being normal, playing normal. So if someone has internet that's not able to like meet the demands and send out a signal every frame that it's supposed to, the game's gonna lag a lot. Most fighting games don't use this. They use what's called like a transaction or rollback model, where a missed input from your game is just assumed to be the same input from the previous frame, and it just looks like if you miss a frame, it just looks like you're doing that same action again, and everybody else's game is just gonna keep going lag-free. And if they were to implement something like that, I think it would be much, much better. And I think there are ways to do that with like player-to-player connections, which everybody thinks that Ultimate is, but it's really not. and that just uses one of the players in the server's internet to host the match, like COD Zombies or Mortal Kombat. I know that because Mortal Kombat, I play a ton of it. Mortal Kombat X, at least. I don't play 11. But I rarely ever experience lag in that game. Another thing I would change or add, we need more game modes, man. We need more things to do on the online. We need different kinds of matches, like the stuff that you could play in Super Smash Bros. Melee, like different preset, different style matches, like sudden death or really, really fast play where the characters move around like they just drank a gallon of fucking Red Bull right after snorting a line, or like game modes like that, you know? Things that could shake up the formula of Smash Bros. A little bit. They could even add the mode from Super Smash Bros. 4 where you customize like every little thing you want to have, like crazy battles, absurd battles where you can be like mini and super fast with low gravity, curry breath, and stamina. You just need to have something that you can go to at the end of like a really crazy long play session of competitive or something like that, and just kind of wind down just to shake things up. Nintendo could also have a game mode where you could like link up with friends and do spirit battles together. You can do it on the spirit boards in the main game, so linking up with people online with spirit battles would be really, really cool. There could be events for different spirit battles, like since Nintendo does that for the main game, they could just extend those events over to the online portion. Alright, number 3 is the GSP and the ranking system. This system needs a major overhaul. Global Smash Power, or GSP, just isn't cutting it, you know? Everybody complains about it, this is the other one that everybody really, really hates. They need to make a competitive mode that would have rankings and have it be different from the casual stuff, like the Four Glory stuff from Super Smash Bros. 4. Now, I play a ton of Rocket League as well, and the ranking system over there isn't really the best there is, but it's definitely better than Smash Ultimate's. And I would say do a simple version of that, where you just match people up based on their online win percentage with that character, and they could do an actual MMR sort of deal, not like the half-assed MMR sort of deal that they do now with GSP, and they could have like other fighting games where you gain some and you lose some, you can't really see how much you gain, and then the higher you are, you gain ranks. Like I'm spitballing, these are definitely not the ranks I want them to be called, but like new, beginner, amateur, pretty good, really good, awesome, you know, those kinds of stuff. And they could implement like a season mechanic, which will go with my next point, I'll elaborate it more on that one. But at the end of the season, you would get rewards that you could customize your Smash tag with based on your rank at the end of the season. They could do it also per character, like with this character, I only have 500 MMR, but with my main, I have 1200 MMR. And the ranks that you could get, or the rewards that you could get from those ranks, would like specify like, oh, I'm a Yoshi Pro or something like that. I think it's really good to incentivize people to play online and then reward them for doing so, because, you know, it takes a lot of time to get that good, so you need an equally good reward. Now, I would say this one's my favorite idea. It's sort of like a faction. Now, hear me out. Don't call me crazy. It kind of relies on both of the previous two things I talked about in order to function properly, but there could be different quote-unquote factions that compete against each other. Like, for instance, the Mario faction, the Link faction, the Kirby faction, and the Fox faction, something like that. And you could, like, compete against each other where, if they do implement the online spirit battles, you could get certain amount of points for completing a spirit battle, and then that would go towards your faction. Or you could do, like, tournaments. If you were to get first place in a tournament, you could get 8 points, and then second place you could get 7, third would get 6, and so on. All those keep getting added into your faction score. Everybody who's in that faction would contribute to that score. And there could be also, like, a big boss, bad spirit, like a boss raid, that would give faction points for each time you knock it out, or before getting knocked out once yourself. So if you kill the boss twice before dying, you get 2 points. If you kill it 5 times, you get 5 points. And at the end of every week or month, or you could do it with the seasons for competitive stuff, your faction would be compared to the other factions, and there could be a sort of reward, like a cosmetic reward, access to the spirits that you don't have in the main game in order to fill up the gallery, hammers that unlock achievements that you can't really seem to unlock yourself. Or it could be decorations to deck out your online profile, more ways to customize your Smash tag, different titles and borders and all that junk, because I think the Smash tag is a really cool concept, just very bare bones at the moment. They could do tons of stuff for like online achievements that reward you for doing well in different online game modes. Like if you win like 100 tournaments, you get a really cool tournament title that you can put on your Smash tag. Something like that. Number 5 is a better way to play with friends. While I don't hate arenas, like I like them. I think they're super cool if you have a group of people that you want to play with. But just having like 2 or 3 people who you want to have a quick match with, it's such a pain to set up an entire arena. You gotta set the skill level. You gotta make a rule set that you both want to do. You gotta say if you want a password or not. And then you gotta make it public or private. And then if you want a password, you gotta slowly type in what the password is. And then the other person has to search for it. And if they can't find it, they have to search again. And when they do find it, if they have a password, you gotta put it in. And then you pick your characters and your stage. It's just a huge deal. I don't know why they made it so complicated. Just, you have Switch IDs. Just have a lobby. Like, set up a match and then just invite someone to the game. Like, it's so simple. I don't know why they don't implement that. But yeah, that's an easy way to make the online better. Number 6, get your rule set straight. This one's infuriating beyond belief. For a company as big as Nintendo to not have this aspect of their online play optimized, it's just embarrassing. So if you guys don't know, most of the people who play online will play 3-stock, 7-minute matches with no items on either an Omega stage or a Battlefield stage. Now that's the kind of the standard agreed upon by like the competitive community. But since Nintendo does not have an effective way to filter out people who have different kinds of rule sets, like this is why a competitive mode would be very, very beneficial. You get matched up with people who have entirely different rule sets. Like you want to play a regular match and you got guys who hop in with like 1-stock items. Like who wants to play that? Nobody. I mean, not nobody. It's just so different from what a lot of people want to play. And if they have like a casual mode where you can just do whatever you want, like doesn't matter the rule set, that would fix that. Or just have that competitive mode where it's just the agreed upon competitive settings. Just do it like Smash 4 did, like an online and a casual. Now last but not least, this one's a big deal to some people, but not too big to me, but I have to mention it. You gotta taunt. I don't know why they don't have taunting. I mean, I understand that they don't want people to get really, really triggered and mad and rage quit and stuff if somebody's taunting them because they just got their ass kicked. But I'm sure if they implemented taunting, the majority of people would see it as a win rather than like dreading playing online because, oh, if I get beat, I'm gonna get taunted on. No. I feel like me, it would just motivate me. Like, I don't want to lose. I don't want to get taunted on. I'm gonna taunt on that little bitch, you know? So, yeah. Well, that's my list of things that I feel Nintendo needs to fix for their online. Short, not really short and sweet, but it feels like it's short and sweet. It's just embarrassing for Nintendo's flagship fighting game that was made in 2018. Like, they have no excuse. It's bad to have that bad of an online mode. But what did you think of my picks? Are there things that you would do differently, or do you agree with what I said? Yeah. Do your normal YouTube stuff. Like, subscribe, share. You know, everything helps the channel. Thank you guys so much for watching the video. And I am Mr. Meech, and I'll see you guys in the next one.